That was pretty good. The front right seat, huh? Oh, we don't throw that. That's good. That's a good.
Spring became the summer. I believed you'd come.
Probably on repeat.
And touching hands, reaching out, touching me, touching you. Thank you. don't seem so lonely. We fill it up with all the words.
Now you walk.
Longer not forever. Burden runs off my shoulder. Love that I heard one hour ago. Touching one, reaching out, touching me, touching you. Sweet Caroline, time's never seemed so good.
Thank you. In 2006, Lacey Clure was the Pennsylvania Player of the Year and broke the Blair County scoring record with 2,167 points.
Between 1992 and 1994, Claysburg Kimmel had five players earn the title of 1,000-yard rushers, including Chad Zembauer, Steve Miller, Brad Wise, and A.A. Ron Burkett.
Derek Tipton, Adam Whetstone, and Jared Musselman each won a PIAA state championship in wrestling.
Marissa Leslie, Monica Ikini, and Christy Mock attended IUP to play softball and made it to the World Series in collegiate softball. In 2006 and 2007, your Lady Bulldog basketball team made two historic state appearances with a trip to the Final Four and the Elite Eight.
In 1994, 1995, 2009, 2011, 2013, and 2018, the Lady Bulldog softball team won the district championship.
Paige Burke recorded the most threes to be made in one game in school history with 11.
In 2014, the softball team was the PIAA state runner-up.
Christopher Critter Musselman was a two-time PIAA state runner-up for Claysburg Kimmel Wrestling.
In 1996, Joe Kennedy was named the Bedford County Athlete of the Year.
Caleb Fleck played college baseball UPJ and was drafted to the Arizona Diamondbacks.
15 Claysburg Kimmel athletes have scored 1,000 points or more in their high school basketball career. Derek Tipton was the only four-time state place winner in wrestling.
Bob Gordon was drafted to play for the Pittsburgh Pirates. Jill Broombaugh was a teammate of the undefeated boys junior high basketball team. She scored over 1,500 points in high school basketball and went on to play at the University of Connecticut.
Jared Musselman holds the all-time winning record for Claysburg Kimmel Wrestling and for District 6 with 141 wins and 9 losses.
In 1991, Adam Claycomb was selected to the All-State Football Second Team, and then in 1993, Sean Fickus was named to the All-State Second Team as well.
In 5 years, Kayla Musselman, Marissa Leslie, and Lacey Clure combined for over 4,500 points in basketball.
In 1989, Karen Dugan was the Altoona Mirror Female Athlete of the Year.
In 1999 and 2000, Claysburg Wrestling was the District 6 Dual Meet AA Champions.
I can't find it anywhere. I worked very hard on this opening. I just wish I had my suit. Anyways, we had to get started. So ladies and gentlemen, thank you all very much for coming tonight. We're already running late. Mr. Helsel, one and only beloved athletic director, is nowhere in the world to be found, and we don't even have a mascot because somebody took my suit. Needless to say, it's been a very, very, very stressful evening. I just wish somebody would tell me where my suit is. Mascots are athletes too, you know. I wish I could get some respect. Any respect at all around here. That would be a nice change. Besides, where's Mr. McLaren? He probably knows where my suit is. Speaking of athletes, I'll tell you what I think of when I think of athletes. I think about a junior on the girls' basketball team scoring her 1,000 points. I think about Claysburg-Kimmel football hosting their very first playoff game at home in school history and winning it 27-8. I think about, well, I think about my Bulldog suit, for one. Anyways, I think about all the playoff appearances. Football, volleyball, Lady Bulldogs basketball, baseball, softball, and all the countless hours of hard work and dedication these students have committed themselves to. Claysburg-Kimmel is home to some very amazing student athletes, those who commit themselves tirelessly to their sports and their studies. The students of Claysburg-Kimmel High School are without doubt the pride and joy of this little town. So, if you all will kindly let me go and look for that darn suit, we're gonna get this thing started.
In every accomplishment and success of Claysburg-Kimmel, each student has made some type of sacrifice throughout their career to reach their goals. Whether it is in high school, sports, their career, or just in life in general, each person has a goal or a desire that they want to accomplish. And whether most of you know it or not, every single student athlete in this room has been the key to our success. So therefore, tonight, our desire, or our goal, of the 2018 Leadership Committee is to congratulate, recognize, and thank all of you for what you have done and for how you have led our school. So at this time, I welcome you to our 2018 Athletic Ceremony.
Before we begin with the recognition of current student athletes, we would like to thank everyone for attending and for supporting us. A special thanks to our administration, coaches, and athletes as well. In the past couple months, our leadership committee has created, organized, and will be leading tonight's banquet. This team consists of 17 members who go above and beyond for Claysburg-Kimmel and continue to show their pride in our school, community, and their peers. At this time, we would like to welcome you to the stage, our 2018 Leadership Committee. Let's give them another round of applause.
Leaders are willing to step up. Leaders aren't afraid to act a little crazy.
Leader is someone who flushes out the competition and cleans up other people's messes. To me, a leader is someone who is loving.
leader is someone who is willing to put themselves out there.
A leader is someone who is not afraid to speak their opinions.
A leader is someone who isn't afraid to be goofy.
A leader is always calm and relaxed in situations.
Leadership means sometimes you have to be a little sassy. Come on, get a move on!
A leader is someone who always knows when to hang in there.
Well, a leader takes a stand.
No matter what goal anyone is working toward, there is one common level that everyone must achieve: hard work. Gordon Hinckley once quoted, "Unless you work hard, nothing grows but weeds." Without the determination of achieving goals and perseverance, hard work becomes nothing but a weed or something that you can just wait to do until later. But what if some consider their goals weeds or pests? Because even after working countless hours, some may just put it off because he or she thinks it will never happen.
I'm sure you're thinking, how is it even possible that some may consider them pests? But has your goal of keeping your house clean always been the thing you enjoy the most? What about that day you don't even want to step foot in the gym? Or getting home from school and just having to go back to work? No matter what, there's a time in your life when you just don't want to do something, but you know that's what you should be doing. Because your goal of becoming the person you want to be isn't going to happen without it. The amount of time and work you sacrifice is only increasing the benefits you're going to receive. Today, as we recognize these students, we acknowledge their hard work. After all, the saying has always been, work hard, play hard.
You know, they asked me why I work hard, and my initial response was working hard has always been something that you could say runs through my veins. But when I thought about it, it all stems from your passions. Your character, your background, and your lifestyle all create the environment for which you want to succeed.
Without every parent, relative, teacher, or friend in this room, the desire for success would have never been created. The will to give it your all, to work countlessly, and to push one another would never exist. Our student athletes are the leaders of our school. And thanks to every one of you, whether you were part of that team that went to the Final Four, were undefeated, won a state or district championship, or even didn't have that season that you had hoped to, your success has inspired student athletes and created the desire to work hard.
Hey, I work hard every day, 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 day. I work hard every day, 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 day. Yeah, but today is my day, it's my day. And no matter what they say, it's my day. La, 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 la. To the spot, feeling real good. Think you gon' talk, but you better not. My homies real hood. They say logic, why you do that? I don't know. Yeah, they used to be like who that? I don't know. Now they know my name wherever I go. Used to think that's what I wanted, but now I just don't know. No, I can't work with that. Look if you're working back. Yeah, I've been working, but I ain't got nothing back. Tell me the dilly now. Hold on, wait, really now. All that you've been talking just silly now. It's as quick as you rise, just as quick as you can fall. Oh no, 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 I can't put that at all. Can't put that at all. I work hard every day, yeah, yeah, yeah. I work hard every day, yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, but today is my day, it's my day. And no matter what they say, it's my day. All she ever wanted was attention and a bunch of other I shouldn't mention. Cause she got daddy issues for days and days. But today, she got to do her ride along with you. So we go around and vibe and vibe and vibe and vibe. I'm trying to live my life, but am I doing it right? Yeah, I'm trying to live my life, but am I doing it right? Tell me I'm the man, you're the man right now. You're the man right now with the whole wide world in the palm of your hand right now. The lights and the cameras and the money and the fame, I'ma do it for the fam right now. I'ma get it for the 301 and the RAWTPAC, cause you know I work hard every day, yeah, yeah, yeah. I work hard every day, yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, but today is my day, it's my day. And no matter what they say, it's my day. La, 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 la.
What you just saw was a highlight reel from this past football season. Our football team had a very successful season. They made the playoffs, they won our first home playoff game, and they successfully forfeited a blowout win. I'm just kidding. With that being said, here's everyone's favorite Duck Dynasty character, Coach Belichick.
Good evening. For those of you who missed our earlier football banquet, when you become named head coach, you got to clean it up a little bit and look a little bit more presentable. Our football team had a very successful season this year, winning our first home playoff game, averaging 185 yards rushing, 137 yards passing per game, totaling 51 touchdowns, 32 sacks, and 11 interceptions. I want to thank the administration, teachers, boosters, parents, players, and fans for supporting Claysburg Kimball football and also supporting me as the new head coach. The expectations are high for this upcoming season, and I think that we will be building on the success that we had from this season as a starting point. Here are some of the players that contributed to the successful season this year. Landon Bowman, Trayton Becker, Kyle Basinger. If you guys can come up, please, after your name's called, if you're in attendance tonight. Kyle Basinger, Ryan Basinger, Levi Brown, Lane Burkett, Preston Bush, Juan Castillo Mock, Corey Chamberlain, Zachary Claycomb, Dalton Coral, Owen Dermer, Jacoby Dotson, Deegan Feather, Hayden Ford, Hunter Gaston, Samuel Gill, Ty Hagen, Kobe Haar, Leighton Helsel, Caden Hallman, Kobe Hunt, Tanner Hunt, Cade Keithley, Isaac Kerr, Liam Lafferty, Cole Lingenfelder, Zachary McCarty, Logan McDonald, Lucas Mock, Seth Musselman, Joseph Noah, Connor Oakes, Mason Patton, Noah Schwartz, Blade Shawley, Gage Tornator, Garrett Vaughn, and Nathaniel Ward. Several awards here to present us. Our first one is a tandem award for offensive playmaker. And it makes sense because both of them went hand in hand to perform and present a lot of great offensive plays. Winners are Ty Hagen and Tanner Hunt. Our next award winner was able to perform a lot of different duties, and not only did he do those things, but he became a very valuable part of our team, and we noticed later in the season that it also became part where teams were game planning to try to take him away. Our Leatherman Multi-Purpose Player Award winner, Lane Burkett. Our next award is our ATM, Money From Anywhere Award. This player scored touchdowns in the air, on the ground, kickoffs, punts. Seemed like just about anywhere we could give him the ball, he was scoring. Our Money From Anywhere Award winner, Kobe Hart. Next award winner is to a great defensive player. This player was a valuable asset to the defense in taking away the leading receiver from the opposing team. Our Brinks Lockdown Award winner, Kyle Biesinger. Our next award goes to one of our offensive linemen. He performed a variety of different positions, filled in as needed, and greatly improved through the course of the season. Home Depot, Most Improved Player Award, Trey Becker. Our last award, Most Entertaining Player. Whether it was taking snaps, stealing the ball, bringing snacks to practice, or just trying to eat a burrito in one bite. Our Pennsylvania Lottery Award winner for Most Entertaining Player, Sammy Gill. I want to just recognize four of our athletes who were chosen to participate this year in the Leser Lumber All-Star Game. There are four players, they contributed greatly to our team, and I know they're going to contribute well in June. Lane Burkett, Dalton Coral, Ty Hagen, Tanner Hunt. Let's give them a round of applause. Thank you guys. You may be seated. Thank you.
or CKHS varsity volleyball team had an outstanding season. They all worked hard and even know how to bump, set, spike their way to the playoffs. At this time, I'd like to announce their coach, Coach Allison McMullen.
Good evening, and thank you all for coming to support all of our student athletes. I would first like to thank my assistant coach who isn't here with us tonight, Rex Whetstone, and also welcome in new assistant coach and junior high coach as well, Kayla Musselman, for us next year. We're all looking forward to our next season. I'm going to start off by thanking our parents first for giving of your time running kids back and forth and putting up with practice changes and times, and it's a lot of work to be a parent and have to run your kids from school to practice to games to tournaments, and I can truly appreciate that. Been there myself, and I know parents deserve as much credit as the kids do. So I'm going to call my team up here, and you can stand on the risers, and then we'll go ahead and give our special awards. Bethany Dominguez, Kayla Fluke, Carson McCready, Justina Brown, Emily Clore, Emily Claycomb, Elizabeth Dotson, Jenica Hunter, Jasmine Kennedy, Olivia Locke, Corinne Wyant, Sabrina Wyant, Heidi Albright, Mackenzie Clemens, Elizabeth Feast, Megan Hartman, Christina Hunter, Gabby McGeary, Jocelyn Schultz, and my manager, Delaney Walter. We ended our season this year with a 12-8 record with another playoff game under our belt. Our girls really, really, really put in a lot of practice this past season, and they really showed a lot of improvement. And I think that we all need to realize a lot of these girls, especially the seniors coming up here, this is just their fourth year. With having the junior high program just instilled 2 years ago, I think they've come a long way, and I think they all deserve a big round of applause. My first award goes to Emily Clore. It's the ultimate competitor. As most of you know, Emily gives 110% in anything she does. She strives for excellence, and she's always a leader. Just an example of the way she's willing to give 110. There was a day we had practice right after band camp, and I knew that something was wrong with Emily, and I just couldn't put my finger on it. And the girls were like, you know, Emily threw up all day in band camp. So I had to go sit her down and tell her she was done for the day. But let's have a round of applause for Emily. Next, I have most team spirited. I have Elizabeth Dotson. Elizabeth is a very quiet girl in general, but she's also a perfectionist. When she's not in the game, because she's tried for many years to be a good server, but she just can't master that one yet. So she shares that position with somebody else, but she's always on the bench cheering for everybody else, and she's always worried about getting that perfect set for everybody. So let's have another round of applause for Elizabeth. Next, I have most digs. This goes to Corinne Wyant. Not only does she do her part in the front line as a setter, she's given me her all in the back row, diving, and she probably leaves the games in the end of the season with the most black and blue marks on her hips, her knees, and her elbows, and she never gives up. Let's have another round of applause for Corinne Lyon. Next, I have my most determined, Justina Brown. Justina strives to motivate the team when we're down. She's always willing to help anyone on the team work on something that they may not have just mastered. And she also has the capability to come through at the serving line when we need the points to get back into the game. Let's have another applause for Justina. And last, I have my Rising Star Award. This goes to Megan Hartman. I'm sure most of you aren't aware, but in volleyball we have different positions, but an outside hitter is normally a pretty tall person. But Megan coming in at 5'4", she's not up there with most of the outside hitters from other schools. But her ability to jump makes her a very valuable asset on our team. And she's always willing to work hard and strive to get better. So let's have a round of applause for Megan. Thank you.
If you'll allow us to take a quick 30-second break, those interested in taking home a ball, put your hands up, we'll come out and throw them at you.
The next award we would like to introduce is the four-year letter winner awards. This is a fantastic accomplishment that very few students can achieve in their high school career. For cheerleading, we have Hunter Evans. And for wrestling, we have Liam Lafferty. Congratulations. Give them another round of applause.
On March 9, 2018, a student at Claysburg Kimmel High School won the Junior World Turkey Calling Champion in Stuttgart, Arkansas. We'd like to recognize Corey Chamberlain for his great accomplishment.
School District Outstanding Accomplishment Award. This award goes to one special senior. She received the Wendy's Heisman Award, the Gold Division Award, and the National Figure Skating Award. Let's welcome to the stage Ms. Hunter Evans.
Never settle for less than gold. You're the best that the world will know. No one ever guess how far you go. You're the greatest that ever was. You're a star, you really are. You're the one shining bright while the rest in the dark. A champion with nerves of stone. You trained for this since the day you were born.
Congratulations to our girls basketball team on their hard work and dedication throughout the season. Please welcome to the stage Coach Jess Viverka.
In 2018 has been a building year for the girls basketball. We started with a young team and one lone senior who stuck out an entire season with us after only playing 1 year, Hannah Gill. Our numbers were low and we worked hard. Jasmine Kennedy, Olivia Locke, Emily Clore, Megan Hartman were our only returning letterers. Even though our numbers were low, we had a winning record of 13-9. We made it to playoffs and realized the only losses we had were to teams that were state champs and state runners-up for District 6. I would like to congratulate and welcome Emily Clore to the 1,000-point club at Claysburg. I know what an accomplishment that is because I am one. Just do not beat me in the 1,000 points. I give these girls credit for the season, and I know good things are in our future of 2018 and 2019. First, Hannah Gill, senior. Emily Clore, junior. Jasmine Kennedy, junior. Olivia Locke, junior. Shady Claycomb, sophomore. Mackenzie Clemens, sophomore. Megan Hartman, sophomore. Kaylee Carson, freshman. And Harley Cavender, freshman. Caitlin Clore, a senior manager. And Delaney Walter, a sophomore manager. first individual award I would like to give. Is to Emily Floor. It is the queen of all trades. The next award is to Harley Cavender, the Rising Star Award. The next award goes to Hannah Gill, the Heart Award. Award goes to Megan Hartman, the Bulldog Award. Thank you, ladies, and I look forward to Tuesday's basketball game at Hollidaysburg Y.
Each year, the athletic department recognizes the most outstanding senior athlete of both genders. At this time, we would like to recognize the female recipient of this award, Michaelyn Bowman. Now we will recognize the male recipient of this award, Tanner Hunt.
Team didn't have a full team. They had an enormous heart for the sport. From the countless days of not eating to the endless empty water bottles and the demanding practices, the team continued to fight and work hard throughout the season. We would like to wish them good luck on the upcoming season.
Please welcome to the stage Coach Matt Musselman.
Good evening, everybody. My first year as head coach was a rebuilding year. We didn't have the numbers that we needed to have to be competitive as a team, but we did have competitive wrestlers. The young men that wrestled on our program this year, even though the team didn't do quite as we expected, we did have 7 place winners at our St. Mary's tournament, and we had 2 district place winners who qualified for regionals this year. So even though as a team we struggled, individually the wrestlers put forward a very, very valiant effort. So now I would like to call up the members of our wrestling team, including our managers, Dalton Coral, Liam Lafferty, Noah Schwartz, Hunter Dively, Cole Lingenfelder, Levi Brown, Zach Claycomb, Kobe Hard, Hayden Ickes, Kate Keithley, Isaac Kerr, and then our managers, Justina Brown, Madison Nisley, Christina Hunter, and Gabrielle McGeary. I have 3 awards to present tonight. The first award is the Iron Man Award. That award is given out to the wrestler who works the hardest in and out of the wrestling room. That award goes to Noah Schwartz. The second award is the Most Improved Wrestler Award. That award this year was given out for the wrestler who improved the most on and off the mat from the previous season. That award goes to Kate Keithley. Last award is the Bulldog Spirit Award. That award is given to the wrestler who best exemplifies team spirit, is willing to work with everyone else on the team. That award was given to Hunter Dively. Hunter's not here, so. So another round of applause, please, for our wrestling team. Thank you.
I'll tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, starting to find pieces of this darn suit. We are going to have a mat.
I found another piece of this darn suit. We're going to have a mascot by the end of the night.
Athletes who have sportsmanship play fair and treat others with respect. This is key to success. Michael M. Bowman and Kyle Biesinger are the two 2018 District 6 Sportsmanship Award winners. Please welcome them to the stage.
This time, we will be recognizing two people that work behind the scenes for CK Athletics. Although they are most likely not recognized by fans at the games, the athletes do recognize them, and we could not perform our best without them. From giving us water at insanely hot games to taping tweaked ankles, these two men do a lot for our athletic program. We would like to thank and recognize Joe Klor and Roger Potsy Langenfelder.
Now we would like to present an award to a dedicated basketball player that scored her 1,000 points in her junior year. This girl worked hard her entire life to meet this humongous milestone in her career.
The Distinguished Accomplishment Award goes to a great person and athlete. Please welcome up to the stage, Emily Klor.
Every sports team has their own groups of fans cheering at different levels of excitement for the team. Claysburg Kimmel has our own group of super fans cheering for each of our teams. Our super fans are the first to be cheerleading team to bring all the hype to our sports. None of this could have happened without a great coach, and here she is, Tracy B. Singer, to talk more about the season.
Good evening. First, I'm just going to call the girls up, and then I'll talk about them for a minute. Hunter Evans, Hannah Gill, Elizabeth Dodson, Julian Herzig, Sabrina Wyant, Danae Wyant, Sydney Hall, Cassie Berkheimer, and every school would not be complete without the best mascot around, Michael Baker. These girls start in August and they work for 3 weeks, 3 hours a day. Longer if I would give the time. They work constantly and beg for more and more practices. I don't get it. I tell them to take breaks. They want to. I don't know. They cheer for over 30 games between football, basketball, and wrestling. They are definitely the highlight of my season. They are just wonderful people. And this bulldog, every day, he scares me to death. If anybody has been to a game and has watched him do his back tucks in those big shoes, I don't get it. And all he says to me is, trust me, Tracy, trust me. I don't know. He's a scary guy. So all of these wonderful ladies, hopefully, I'm losing two seniors, but everyone else will be back next year, so that's very exciting. I have three awards to give out tonight. Let me see who they're going to do first. The first award I have is the Can Do Attitude Award. This is for the girl who gives such a positive attitude as a strong leader. She was a strong leader in junior high while she was able to tackle everything we asked of her in varsity. She cheered with varsity this year also. Sydney Hall. The next award that I'm giving is the Friend to All Award. This is to the girl that is very agreeable. She is kind to all of her teammates while showing initiative among her peers, and that is Julian Herzig. The last award that I have is for Best All-Around Cheerleader. This is the girl who helps create new material for the team. She is our best in jumps. She has strong motion. She's smiling. She has a great voice. She brings a lot to the team. She'll teach other girls as needed, and that is for Hunter Evans. If we could give them all one more round of applause. Thank you.
Victor Bulldog, have you ever gotten your ankles broken?
In fact, I have. This season, our last practice before our first game, my bestest friend, Ben Wyland, put his foot right in the way of mine when I was going for a layup, and I tore my ankle in half. So in fact, I did get my ankles broken.
So Ben, what was the highlight of your season?
The highlight of my season was when I broke my best friend's, Michael Baker's, ankles in more than one way.
So, have you broken any ankles?
Well, yeah. And Michael's, too.
So, how is sitting on the bench this season?
You know, being a player, this is pretty nice, actually. I enjoyed it.
Well, that's good. So, overall, how was this past season?
Well, we didn't come out on top every game, but we definitely did our hard work in the practice and during the game.
How did basketball make you a better person?
It gave me a better work ethic. It made me a better team member.
We've seen you practicing in your off-season at the Queen School. How has your hard work paid off?
Well, I think my hard work has paid off exponentially. I've done so much shooting drills and handling drills that I think I'm going for a position change next year. I think I'm going to try out the left bench.
What was your favorite song in this season?
My favorite would have to be Take Me Home, Country Road.
Seasons after seasons, our boys are always working hard on the court, breaking ankles, and taking names. Welcome to the stage, our basketball coach, Mike Harris.
Just one little note, if you ever have a dance or an event, you need a DJ, please do not ask Mr. Helsel to do that. So our season, kids battled hard, as Kyle said on the video. We battled hard in every game. You know, we lost some players to injury, but the kids' attitude was great. They worked really hard, and I'd like to thank all the parents that came to the game, supported the team. I'd like to thank all the administration, and I'd like to thank my assistant coaches, Coach McMullen and Coach Kulik, who, you know, who did a great job with helping out with the attitude, my attitude, and players, and we're really there to support the players, and did a fantastic job. And let's give everybody a round of applause that was involved there. I'd like to announce the players, so if you could please, when your name's called, come on up. Nick Mislanek, Spencer Mock, Evan Ritchie, Landon Bowman, Sam Dodson, Dominic Francona, RJ Helsel, Alex Kulik, Mike Baker, Kyle Glass, Ben Wyland, and Hayden Ford, and our manager, Cody Swindell. There he is. So we have some awards we're going to give out tonight. I'll tell her a story before the awards. So we're in Northern Bedford this year in that purgatory they call a gym that's more like an ice skating rink for those who have ever been there. We're down by 4 points with 20 seconds left. It's total chaos on the court. There's bodies flying everywhere, people screaming. Coach McMullen, I think, was out of it on the bench. Somebody hit him in the head with a ball. I'm not really sure what happened over there. Nick Mislanek hits a three with about 16 seconds left. We're down by one. So it was a little back and forth. We end up fouling Northern Bedford. Kitty goes to foul, misses them both, misses the second one. Alex Kulik gets the rebound with about 5 seconds left. Flies down the floor and gets killed at the basket, like just fouled. Referee blows the whistle. He's going to go to the foul line. So his dad's on the bench, saying every Bible verse he knows. I think you made up a couple. I'm not really sure. I knew the game was over because I thought there's no way he's missing those. And sure enough, He made them both. We won the game with what, 2 seconds left. They didn't. They got a shot off, didn't come close, and that's our first award tonight, the Mr. Clutch Award to Alex Cooley. Next award goes to our rebounding champion, who vowed that he would never set foot back in the school again once basketball season was over. And he did. He's not here tonight. Spencer Mock with our Windex award for cleaning the glass at every game. Averages about 14 rebounds a game. Our dedication award. This player never missed, since I've been here, never missed any workouts, never missed games, practices, and that would be Evan Ritchie, our dedication award. We are, our team is blessed with a very good leader. We have a very good leader on the floor. This next award is the floor general award. And I'm not a real big micromanager during games. I think it's important to let the players, they know what's going on at practice. They go out there and they do their job. And we have a really, really good leader who really does a great job of calling out plays, knowing what defenses we're going to run. And that's Kyle Glass, floor general. The Boosters organization bought us a shoot-away couple years ago, which is a big contraption he set up in the gym, and the players can shoot, balls come down through the net, and they roll out to the players. So one of our players is bragging about how they got this engineering award at Votech. They're saying, "Coach, I got this engineering award at Votech, it's great." I'm like, "Hey, good for you, that's awesome, man. That's great, you know." So I said, "Hey, while you're at it, why don't you go set up the shoot away so we can get some shooting in the summer?" Couldn't do it. I said, "Coach, I don't know how this works. I can't get this open. It won't work." And I said, "Are you kidding me? You got an award from the Votech for engineering. I think you got that award in a Cracker Jack box." And this next award is the Cracker Jack Award. That's Nick Maslanik. Yeah. This next player isn't here tonight, but I, other than the fact that I was there last year on the road at Bellwood when he got thrown out, and I had to go to the referee meeting and watch the video as they described how to properly throw out a player of the game, and this is how you do it. And I'm like, "Oh yeah, I was there. I remember that game." But this year, he did not get thrown out. He stayed the course, and that's Landon Bowman. Let's give another round of applause to the team for the hard work. Thank you.
varsity baseball team had an impressive season. With tough games and hard-fought wins, they persevered through it all. They managed to make it to the second round of the PIAA District 6 playoffs.
Let's please welcome to the stage Coach Harris. No, not you, Coach Harris. That Coach Harris.
Good evening. The varsity baseball team finished the year with an 8-7 record. When I look at whether or not the season was successful, I look at how we were playing at the end of the year. Did we get better? This year was kind of a strange year because it seemed to rain every single day. When it rains, it's kind of hard to go outside and do a lot of things. So when the rain finally let up at least a little bit, we started to get in our groove and we played our best baseball at the end. We ended up losing in the district semifinals to the eventual district champ and top-ranked team in the state. We were a very young team with only three seniors. And even though we're losing those seniors,
I could interrupt. I see Baker Bulldog found his costume.
Anyways, we will now go into our awards. Before we do that, I would like to thank all the parents for supporting the kids this year, running players around. I know that's not an easy thing. I'd like to thank the boosters. I'd like to thank my assistant coaches. There's a lot of people in this community that really care about our student athletes, especially in the baseball end. There's a lot of people putting a lot of time and money into our kids, and that's a great thing. That being said, as I call your name, would you please come up to the podium? Deegan Feather, Ty Hagen, Tanner Hunt, Kanan Burkett, Dom Francona, R.J. Helsel, Zach McCarty, Lucas Mock, Zach Claycom, Kyle Glass, Kobe Haar, Nate Helsel, Hayden Ickes, Seth Musselman, Connor Oaks, Logan Ridenour, Corey Chamberlain, and Parker Diver. The first award that we're going to give is the Silver Slugger Award. This award is given to the highest batting average on the team. Bulldog, I'm about ready to touch your face here in a minute. The Silver Slugger Award goes to the player with the highest batting average. This player is probably the most improved player that I've ever been around. And the reason that he is where he's at today is pretty simple. Hard work, and he plays a ton of baseball. He plays year-round. He always works on his games, willing to stay after and take extra swings in the cage. With a .395 batting average, the Silver Slugger Award goes to Dom Francona. Next award is the Golden Glove Award, and when I was deciding who to give this award to, there was two names that kept popping up, but I couldn't decide which person to give this award to, so we decided to give it to both of them. The Golden Glove Award is an award to who has the best glove, who's the best fielder on the team, and these two, the way they turn double plays is just like watching the big leagues. These guys do it the way it's supposed to be done. They work hard. They take thousands upon thousands of ground balls, and the Golden Glove Award goes to Kyle Glass and Connor Oaks. The next award is the Senior Leadership Award. This award goes to the senior that exhibits leadership qualities, whether it's through his words or his actions. This player has started for me since day one, 4 years ago, and is as fierce of a competitor as I know. He wants to win more than anything. Okay, competition is great, and he is a true example of somebody who gives everything, leaves everything on the field. He always gives 100%. The Senior Leadership Award goes to Tanner Hunt. The next award is the Bulldog Hustle Award. This award goes to the player who works harder than any player on the team. This particular player does everything 100%. I always preach to these guys to do the little things, and someday it will win us a ball game. And this particular player always does the little things. He always backs up players, runs out, everything. Always gives 100%. The Bulldog Hustle Award goes to Kanan Burkett. The next award is the Rising Star Award, and this award goes to the player who we are expecting a lot in the future. This particular player, we moved up as a ninth grader. When I've moved ninth graders up in the past, it's because they were going to start, and we told this particular player that he may not start, he may not play a lot, and it's just because of the people in front of him. He moved up, he worked hard every single day, he got better, and we're expecting a lot of him in the future. The Rising Star Award goes to Parker Divert. And the last award is the Cool Calm Freshman Award. The Cool Calm Freshman Award goes to a freshman who does not act like a freshman. This particular player started every single game. He looks like he is a senior out there, and we're expecting big things from him in the future. The Cool Calm Freshman Award goes to Corey Chamberlain. Thank you.
Someone who has super strength or has the ability to read minds? In our small town, a hero is defined as something else. A hero is someone who cherishes their family and gives back to the community through them. An example of a hero in our community is Mr. Brent Wright. Mr. Wright was someone who had dedicated his entire life to supporting Claysburg Kimmel Athletics, starting with his daughter, Mrs. Stephanie Ritchie, who, as we all know, is now a math teacher at our school, and continuing with his grandchildren, Evan and Emma Ritchie. The heroes of Claysburg Kimmel define our town and make us known as the loving and supportive community that we are. Tonight, in his memory, we will honor the Hero Award to Mr. Wright's family. Will the Wright family please come up?
I'm getting growled out back here, so apparently I'm out of line here. We, for those that don't know, we have a co-op agreement with Chestnut Ridge for varsity track and field. This is actually our second year. Last year we had 7 track and field athletes. This year we only had 2. However, at this time, we do want to recognize them for their hard work and dedication to a very, very tough sport, very competitive. Those 2 athletes are Sadiq Smouse and David DJ Miller. If you would come up, please. Sadiq's the only one. So that Sadiq knows, he actually earns a Chestnut Ridge letter and a Claysburg Kimmel letter for track and field. That is an agreement with PIAA and Chestnut Ridge. Thank you, Sadiq.
Our next award is to congratulate a person who is the face of our school spirit and never fails to get the Claysburg community excited. Football games and pep rallies are always going to be better because of Baker Bulldog. Congratulations to Michael Baker, and thank you for all the laughs, backflips, and hard work you put into a BR mascot. Please come out on stage to receive your greatest mascot award.
And Ben's up here, so try not to break your ankle on the way out.
First, let's start off by congratulating the girls softball team on winning the District 6 Single-A softball game. This year, the girls have also won the Southern Hunnic Tournament. In this tournament, 4 members of the softball team have made the All-Star team and have gone above and beyond to achieve and make their coaches proud. Congratulations to the girls and keep on advancing in the state playoffs. We would now like to announce the coach, Mr. Mike Barberini.
Good evening. I'd like to introduce the girls softball team. Starting with our freshmen, Janae Dotson, Haley Reed, Madison Fry, Jaden Rowe, Harley Cavender, Cassidy Reiner, Emily Wyant, and Olivia Bouchard. Our sophomore, Megan Hartman. Our juniors, Jasmine Kennedy, Corinne Wyatt, Emily Floor, Nikki Musselman, McKinley Bauman, Justina Brown, and Madison Nisley. Our seniors, Raylan Grable and Michaelyn Bauman. Getting used to this.
We were at Haas's. And we were about to leave after we ate, and all the little servers came over with a birthday cupcake. Said, "We understand it's your birthday." I did age another year after that game that we played the other day. I'd like to give out a couple of awards. I may have to tackle this guy. Well, I can't see if you take my glasses. The first award is a freshman. This up and coming, a rising star award, goes to Haley Reed. Another freshman award goes to a girl who worked all winter to get better, to make our team better, and I don't know if we'd be where we were without her. Most improved player goes to Olivia Bouchure. The next award goes to a Silver Slugger Award, which goes to Emily Clore. Our next award goes to a person who made an outstanding play during the season and helped us win a game. We played West Branch here and won 2-0 in the last inning. They had runners on first and second with nobody out, and this person fielded a ball, tugged the girl, and threw it to first for a double play, and that was Raylan Grable. The next award is a Bulldog Award. We give this to a player who shows the characteristics of how I want our team to be represented. And that award goes to Michaelyn Bauman. Again, we are playing in the state playoffs, and it will be on Monday. We're hoping it's at Penn State sometime on Monday. 5 o'clock at Penn State on Monday. I'd also like to thank our managers, Delaney Walter and Emily Clore. Also, my assistant coaches, Karen Dugan, Russ Nisley, Tony Cavender, and Allison McMullen. Makes my job a lot easier having these people around. Thank you.
knew this was a mistake. I want to apologize to Coach Barberini for the harassment. I hope that's not on video anywhere. At this time, the athletic department recognizes any senior who's involved in athletics. We want our students to be involved. Obviously, there are good things that happen when kids are supervised in activities and have opportunities to develop skills and to be recognized for that and those efforts. The feeling those girls had yesterday, you can't buy. You can't purchase that anywhere. It doesn't matter how much money you have, where you come from. That feeling is unbelievable. And a lot of student athletes don't get to feel that. So one of the reasons we are trying to up ceremonies such as this is to get some excitement, generate excitement within our student body. So at this time, we are going to recognize all senior athletes, and they will be asked to come up, and we have a special framed letter for all of our senior athletes.
Hunter Evans. Hannah Gill. Spencer Mock, Carson McCready, Liam Lafferty, Bethany Dominguez, Caitlin Clore, Kayla Fluke, Raylan Grayville, Evan Ritchie, Nicholas Winslanek, Lane Burkett, Owen Dermer, Tanner Hunt, and Noah Schwartz. Thank you. Let's give all of our senior athletes a round of applause.
It hasn't been easy in administration for our new superintendent to get used to Claysburg Kimmel High School, and I'm sure it hasn't been an easy year for our principal either. These two men have done so much for our school, and we are proud to have a superintendent and a principal like them. Here are the recipients of the awards for our administration appreciation awards, Mr. Darren McLaren and Mr. Stephen Pushkar.
At this time, if we could have all football players and all baseball players report to the back of the auditorium. All football, all baseball, please, at this time. We were able to earlier give a hero award to a wonderful family that I've known for many years. We also have a second hero award to celebrate someone that I've known for a long time. You know, I was asked to present this award, so I looked up the word success and also successful people, and it led me to a book which I had actually read previously called Training Camp by John Gordon. Some of the things that this book says, successful people know what they truly want. The best want it more, the best are always striving to get better, fear success, not failure, the best do ordinary things better than everyone else. We've all heard these. Unfortunately, that does not describe this person. It describes someone else. This person likes to ask questions. When I became the AD, I realized that that's the number one rule of an athletic director. To answer questions, the same questions. And this person at times likes to growl at me with those questions. Matter of fact, this person actually broke Caleb Musselman's record for most complaints in 1 year. At last count, we're over 2,000 complaints. Kayla, as some of you know, was awarded her 1,000 point ball at halftime at a game, because she repeatedly told me, I don't have a 1,000 point ball in the trophy case.
That's false.
This person again broke that record. But what this person is Claysburg. When someone asks me about Bulls Creek, I think of this person. When someone asks if a bear was shot at near a gas tank, I think of this person. I think of this person when I think of our wonderful school district. This person, as Henry David Thoreau once stated, the language of friendship is not words, but meanings. This award recipient defines friendship to me. When a bus is running late or while not showing up, he blames me first. I wouldn't have it any other way. When I call and say, hey, the junior high players need to go to the elementary, and he answers, tell them to walk, I laugh. And then he says, I'm serious. But he always comes through. That request from this man was as follows in terms of repeatedly asking a question. It was more of a statement. I want my grandson's jersey. You see, Zach Claycomb's away jersey, this recipient's grandson, was damaged last season. And due to that, I needed to purchase a new one. We typically get rid of those jerseys. However, wanted to save this for a very special occasion. At this time, let's give a warm round of applause for Mr. George Hard. Would George Hard please come forward to receive your award?
On behalf of the varsity baseball team, we would like to thank Mr. McLaren on allowing us to have our first ever night game at Claysburg Kimmel High School. This night was very successful, and our kids would love to have more night games next year, as this night was one to remember. At this time, we would like to thank Mr. McLaren and have him come up on a seat on stage to receive his thank you award. We are very grateful for all you do.
At this time, we would also like to congratulate our CK administration and teachers by making a goofy video and showing the funny side that you guys don't always get to see.
Everybody start to make some noise. We're coming back out throwing more stuff.
We have approximately 8 minutes. We're going to finish up 8 to 10 minutes. And then for everyone, please stay for refreshments in the gymnasium. Please stay for refreshments in the gymnasium. At this time, we want to recognize three very special, very important people who do wonderful things for Claysburg-Kimmel by volunteering their time. They often say the greatest gift you can give in life is giving back to others, and those three ladies define that statement. Please come to the front. I know they're gonna be upset with me, but please come to the front. I call your name, Dottie, Carol, and Joyce. Now, I gave these ladies lots of notice about tonight's ceremony. Actually, I seen one of them at the pizza shop last night, so I forgot to let them know that tonight was the night. So they came, and they are greatly appreciated. Let's give them another round of applause. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Mr. McLaren. I'm the new superintendent here. I started here in December, and I was actually hired in October, and Mr. Housel asked me if I could talk a little bit about my first experience with Claysburg Athletics. And I came to my first football game, and Mr. Housel said, you know, I'm going to be running all around, but I'm going to have somebody meet you when you get out of the car and take you to the press box. So I'm thinking school board president, mayor of Claysburg, Coach Harris met me at my car. And I actually thought about turning around, but I went up into the box, and as soon as I got up there, there were two guys running the clock, and they were picking on Mr. Housel. And I said, who are those guys? And he said, oh, that's Mr. Barberini and Mr. Hartman. They're elementary teachers. And I said, who's the guy in the orange shirt? And he goes, oh, that's Mr. Imler. He only wears orange shirts. And I thought, so he said, I got to warn you. He said, our fans are kind of crazy here. So the game started, and if you didn't know, I've coached football, and I used to be the athletic director of my old school. And the first close play, the fans go crazy. And I look down on the sidelines, and there's this big guy down there with an army hat on, and he looks like he's going to rip somebody's head off. And I said, who's that? And he said, oh, that's his wife's on the school board. And I thought, whoa, I'm going to like this place. So I remember on the ride home, my wife texted me and said, how things go tonight? And I said, they really like their sports. I said, I think I'm going to like this place. I said, my only complaint is, whoever ordered those football jerseys, they should fire them. You can't read the numbers. But on a serious note, and only Mr. Hels away at about 10 o'clock this morning, he said, I need you to present the leadership award, and I need you to talk a little bit about leadership. So I'll keep this brief. I've been fortunate over the years to listen to some great speakers. And the kids are always in my office, because my office is right beside Mr. Helsel's, and they know I'm a big Penn State fan. And I was fortunate enough to hear Coach Paterno speak, Urban Meyer, Steve Spurrier. But there's one person that always talked about leadership who I really respected, and that was Lou Holtz from Notre Dame. And I remember being at a conference one time, and he talked about the five characteristics of leadership. So for all you athletes out there, if you can remember these five things that he said are keys to leadership. The first thing he said was attitude. He said everyone will face adversity at some point in their lives. What makes a great leader is how you respond. The second thing he talked about was a passion to win. And I'll never forget, he said, remember the acronym WIN, W-I-N. What's important now? The third thing he said, focus on your purpose and avoid distractions. Focus on why you can do something and don't listen to the other people. The fourth thing he said was be a dreamer. He said everyone needs four things in your life. Something to do, someone to love, someone to believe in, and something to hope for. He said this something to hope for is your dreams. It's something you want to accomplish. And like the Nike commercial says, just do it. And the final characteristic, and probably the most important, is he said always make good choices. And he left us with three tips to always make good choices. The first is always do what's right. Next, do everything to the very best of your ability. And finally, just show people you'll care. You care. With that in mind, if you keep those characteristics in your mind, everything you do, you'll all be successful. I'm very happy to be at Claysburg. You have a great school here. The kids are awesome. I love working with them every day. The leadership team has been working for weeks, and I think we need to give them and Mr. Helsel a big round of applause for putting this program together tonight. This year, Mr. Helsel chose two Claysburg Kimmel Leadership Awards. And from my experience, I think everyone on the team was eligible, but he had to pick two. The first one goes to, and it says on the trophy, a leader is a person who you will follow to a place you would not go by yourself. And that award goes to Maggie Nisley. The second leadership award, the trophy reads, the quality of a leader is reflected in the standards they set for themselves. And that award goes to Corinne Wyatt.
Directors for their commitment and positive contributions to their student athletes, their schools, and their surrounding community. Our district is very fortunate to have a person leading us that represents all of these qualities. So this year's recipient is Mr. Brian Helsel from Claysburg Kimmel. He can show us the and stand strong for all of us. Even though another school year is about to come to an end, we cannot forget to recognize these students based on their amazing accomplishments. Seniors, thank you for four memorable years. Remember the journey, but you still have so many ways to grow. Juniors, your high school years are coming to an end, almost as quickly as the flash of a camera. Your greatest year is ahead of you. Work towards your goals. We have many milestones to aim for in the next year. Underclassmen, enjoy the years while they last. Don't be afraid to ask for help and always do your best. And most of all, students,
Work hard. There is not one person out there going to stop you but yourself. Teachers, administration, family, and guests, thank you for supporting your community and for teaching us how to be a leader. To conclude our ceremony, our students on the leadership committee have made a few special videos we thought you might enjoy. As you watch these couple of videos, take a moment to realize why we have been so successful. Because remember, there is no secret to success.
That tonight's gonna be a good night.
Thank you all for attending tonight, and most importantly, congratulations to all student athletes. At this time, we kindly invite all of you to the gymnasium for a meal. Thank you.
Hold up a second, just watch this.